Mr. Speaker, pursuant to Clause 2A(1) of Rule 9, I seek recognition to give notice of my intent to raise a question of the privileges of the House. The form of the resolution is as follows.
Recognized.
Censuring Representative Ilhan Omar of Minnesota.
I see what she's going for there.
Yeah.
Or she honestly doesn't know because she didn't pay attention to geography. I'm not sure, but that is Marjorie Greene. And she was, as you saw, talking about Ilhan Omar, and based on a completely purposefully mistranslated version of a speech that the congresswoman gave, and wants to censure her. Now, censuring is what she is trying to do on the floor of the House. She would love to go much further than that, as she will explain on Twitter.
Today I introduced a censure resolution against Ilhan Omar. And the reason why I did that, and I'll just say this, censure is not going far enough. If it were up to me, we would expel Ilhan Omar and deport her out of the United States. Her comments are outrageous. She's acting as a foreign agent within our very government. She said the U.S. government will only do what Somalians in the U.S. tell them to do. They will do what we want and nothing else. They must follow our orders, and that is how we will safeguard the interest of Somalia. She also said, for as long as I am in Congress, Somalia will never be in danger. Its waters will not be stolen by Ethiopia or others. Sleep in comfort knowing I am here to protect the interest of Somalia from inside the U.S. system. Ilhan Omar needs to be censured, but censure is not enough. I'm telling you right now, she is acting as a foreign agent on behalf of a foreign country.
So first of all, I'd like to give some credit to the congresswoman for mostly pronouncing those words correctly. So she clearly prepped for that. Kudos to the congresswoman. But that's insane. Not only because the quotes that she read are not anything that Ilhan Omar has ever said, but even if she had said those things, you cannot deport an American citizen, you ignorant monster. Or if you can, if that's the new world, well then I would like to start a social media campaign to deport Marjorie Greene. And I know what you're thinking, where would we deport her? She's not from another country. I don't care, we're in bizarro world now. There are any number of planets where I think she would be quite comfortable. Deport Marjorie Greene. See, this is the crazy world that they want us to live in. And I want to go to the actual comments that Ilhan Omar made. We're going to get to the politics of this and all that. But here's a little video that contrasts what right wingers are lying about what she said and what she actually said. Take a look at the gap here.
The translation on the clip claimed that she said this: the US government will only do what Somalians in the US tell them to do. They will do what we want and nothing else. They must follow our orders, and that is how we will safeguard the interest of Somalia. Now CNN translated her speech. Here's what she actually said. Quote, the United States government would do what we tell them to do. We need to have confidence as Somali people. We live in this country. This is the country that we pay taxes in. This is the country where a girl was born from you all who is sitting in Congress.
We might have millions of people watching this show, but you can be the difference maker, because we just need 1% of our audience to be paid members, and then this show can be around forever. So you can make that difference. Click join now.
So a few small differences between the version the right wing was pretending she had said and what she actually said. Now it actually arguably gets worse than what we've already shown you, but I do want your commentary on her trying to censure Ilhan Omar for something that she did not at all say.
That's absurd, but in Marjorie Taylor Greene's world, absurdity seems to rule the day. It's offensive, it's absurd. Those are kind of the coins of the realm in Marjorie Taylor Greene land. It's a fact that even if the utterances that Marjorie Taylor Greene read through, which were completely twisted as we've just seen, even if those were accurate, I don't see any reason to censure her. I don't see any reason, you know. So the Ilhan Omar censure, I think is bankrupt even with this twisted, ridiculous, made up quote. But Marjorie Taylor Greene shouldn't be even in Congress on a tour. She's offensive, she's grotesque, and she deserves not to get any media oxygen whatsoever.
Yeah, it's so fascinating, like George Santos got booted. He lied, like in like a crazy person to get into office. And then in office, he was kind of just a regular corrupt politician. Marjorie Greene is a monster. She's one of the craziest people that's ever served in government, and yet she remains. And I'll get to how she is even more guilty than she might already seem in this case. Because of course, you can't call for the deportation of a US citizen. Someone who's been a citizen since they were, I believe, 12 years old. For 2.5 decades, she's been a citizen. And you think you get to deport her. Gee, I wonder why you think that you get to make that call. And no matter how many decades of her life Ilhan Omar spends in this country, she will never truly be an American citizen. I wonder why that is. But let's move to a little bit more of this. I want to get at least a bit of what Representative Omar has actually said in response to all of this. She said, when I heard that people who call themselves Somalis signed an agreement with Ethiopia, this is getting to the actual politics of what she was talking about in this speech in Minneapolis back last month, many people reached out to me and said I needed to talk to the US government. They asked, what would the US government do? My answer was that the US government will do what we tell the US government to do. That is the confidence we need to have as Somalis. So that means, it means two things. First of all, if you believe that the US government should change its foreign policy, then have confidence in yourself and advocate for it. And also, if we don't ask for it, it's not going to happen. That's what that means. But I want to broaden this to a different context. Here, this is about a water dispute involving a Somalia and a breakaway section and Ethiopia and all of that. But the point that Marjorie Greene seems to be making is, if you advocate strongly for our approach to a different country to shift based on what we hear believe, if you, you know, theoretically share like an ancestry with another country or a kinship, and you care enough about that other country that you want to change our policies towards it, that you deserve to be deported. I am assuming she means that only in the case of Somalia, because if she believes that like people who theoretically might have family in Israel or might be Jewish by descent or something care strongly about what happens in that country, I don't think she would want them deported for trying to lobby the US government on its policy towards the region. Does anybody believe that? Or is it just a thing that that would be allowed? Or, you know, if you care about Finland or something and you're Finnish, you can advocate for a foreign policy there. But it's Africa, suddenly it's different. Of course, it's ridiculous, but that is 100% what she means, and it's based purely in her racism.
She's talking to her constituency, and that's who she should be talking to. She's representing them. That's why she's a representative. That's the way it works.
Yeah. I want to end with one more, like if we need an indictment of like Marjorie Greene, I don't think that we do, but one more. So that happened yesterday. She read something online that she liked the sound of, didn't care to look into whether it was true, and turned what should have just been a retweet, a boneheaded conspiracist racist retweet into action on the House floor. And you might think that's as bad as it can get, but actually it gets worse because that was yesterday. And she was debunked, she was mocked online, she was like viciously attacked, as she should be for doing this. This morning, she tweeted, thank you, Representative Finstad, for co-sponsoring my resolution to censure foreign agent Ilhan Omar. She's still pretending that that's what Representative Omar said. Wow. She knows that it's not. She doesn't care. She's lying to her constituents. She's lying to her followers on social media because she cares more about her hatred for a prominent, outspoken woman of color than she does about the truth.
And she's seen it work. Honestly, John, she's seen it work. I mean, just pounding away with the lie has sort of now been the new MO on the right.
Yeah.
So sadly, it works.
Well, and they censured Representative Tlaib.
Thank you.
You know, there's sort of a pattern to what Marjorie Greene is advocating for here. I'm not smart enough to figure it out. Maybe we can get Congresswoman Greene on the matter. But anyway, it's ridiculous. Thankfully, with it being so thoroughly and obviously debunked, it shouldn't go anywhere. But they have control of the House, so honestly, who knows?